Hey guys, it's Kevin. Last year you emailed me asking about if I can recommend a digital microscope that's not super expensive and also have decent quality to work on small things on the circuit board. I'm going to recommend this sub-$100 microscope. The model is TOMLOV DM201 SE. The monitor is 7-inch IPS screen. It says can do 1080p. There are lots of microscopes that they can do 1080p. However, they're really slow, so when you work on it, it's really jiggery. But this one is IPS screen and has improved response time, so when you want 1080p, it's super smooth. Also, this machine has a better image processing and color correction, so it gives you better contrast, which is critical for your work. It also comes with 32GB memory card. It took me a while to find it. I thought I lost in the package. Actually, they already inserted it in the back of the monitor. The setup is easy. Firstly, we screw on the 10-inch bracket. This nut controls the angle of the bracket. It's already preset by the manufacturer. However, I'll show you how to correct it. Then you tighten the black ring, which will stabilize the bracket. Then you release the two screws on the bracket and insert the LCD panel. The knobs in the back controls the up and down of the LCD screen and also does your manual zoom in and zoom out. The power is using for this model. We're going to put the power into this USB port on the base. That's going to require the longer piece of the USB cord. You can see the two lamps on the base light up, and here I can control the light intensity. Isn't it amazing for this inexpensive microscope? Now on the base, you'll find an outlet for 5 volts, and that's going to be output 5 volts to your scope. So we plug it in. You're supposed to untighten the nut to adjust the angle, but here I just brute force it because I cannot find the wrench. And make sure the bracket is 90 degrees with the base. Because the base is black, lots of people think the machine didn't turn on because their screen is black. Put something there and you're going to see it. To focus, just twist this lens and it will be in focus. If you are a coin collector, the largest coin you can do to put whole coin in one picture is about 4 centimeters, which is about the size of a whole dollar. You can manually zoom in and zoom out by turning the knobs. And after that, you can use as a digital zoom. So overall, the zoom is between 10 to 1200x. And you can see it's super detailed. To zoom digitally, just press left and right arrow on the screen or on your remote control. The remote control basically just duplicated buttons on your screen. It also supports Mac OS and Windows. However, if I buy a scope, I want to look at scope. I don't want to look at the monitor. If you press and hold the menu button for 3 seconds, you can switch between photo, video, and playback mode. To record a video or take a picture, just press OK and it will start. To stop the recording, just press OK again. And of course, you can do the same thing on the monitor too. And now it's recording. To control the main light, which is top-down light, and you can press left and right arrow. If you press and hold, that's the digital zoom. But if you just click once, that's the turn off and turn on the light. And if you find that there is too much reflection, you can put in the reflection filter, which is that all cone shape, and just screw it on. And it's much better. Okay, let's make it work. And we have a WF3640 mainboard, and it has this air 0X9A, and most likely is the F1 fuse. Can you see the F1? Is that fuse get blown off? I made a couple of videos, but this one I'll show you a detailed step to replace the fuse. Because the fuse is so small, lots of you bought the replacement but don't know how to install it. Isn't the color great? Not only the color is great, but also this IPS monitor, you can view it at any angle, which is great if you are doing some demonstration or you are discussing the board with somebody. One thing about those microscopes is their base are built with aluminum. I wish one day they're going to build it with iron so I can stick a magnet on it. So I'm putting an iron base, which I can use the magnet to secure the mainboard. Heat up your iron to 350 to 360 degrees and clean it out first. And then what we want to do is cut pin the iron and put a little bit of solder on it. And you should see the solder stay with iron. You can see it stayed there. So this one is probably tinned. If you find that the iron is like Teflon, you put the solder on it, it just drips down. You should keep doing this or rub it more to make sure you can tin it. And make sure you use the sharpest head for the iron and do not use those things look like a big block. Eventually you feel your iron is sucking the solder. So when you have a solder tin touching, it sucks everything in there, see? And you can clean it off, or what I like to do, I just put it down there and just put it away and let it burn. Okay, now I'm ready to record a video. Clean the tape first and we're ready. Our problem is there's solder on both sides. So if we put iron on one side, this side melts, and we go to another side, the whole thing will become solid again. I've seen people do this back and forth and then remove it. However, for me, I'll just put a big drop of solder on it. And you can see, I just dig the whole thing out. And you can see there's a big lump of solder on it. I need to clean up with something called solder wick. I'll put a link in the description. To make sure we have a good bond and also clean out the solder as much as possible, we put in something called a solder flux, and also I'll put it in the description. Your final result will be really clean and really flat contact because we're going to slide the fuse over. You cannot have lumps on it. Here's the fuse. It's funny, I got the email said, oh, your fuse doesn't look like a F1 fuse at all. I said, take off the package. It is in a white envelope. After you take it out of the envelope, you're going to see one side is white and the top side is black. That'll help you to say which side is the correct side. Actually, there's no correct side. They'll work. It's neat to have the upper side going up, right? I like to tell people, take out a dollar bill, and the size is about the pupil of that dollar bill. If you cannot work on it, and just give to somebody professional that can do it for you. Okay, we have over F1 fuse right there, and it always better let the solder wire touch the iron than other way around. So we'll put the iron there and use the solder to touch it. That will put a drop on one side of the contact points. Now I use a dentist tool, just touch the flux a little bit so it's a little bit sticky, and I can use that to push the little fuse a little bit over and almost touch the solder. And now I melt the solder and touch it. Now I can put the solder on the other side and still the iron in first and touch it. And now go back and do the first contact points again. Beautiful. And now I can take out a multimeter and test. And you can see, as though this scope is not that expensive, it has so many functions, easy to use, and the image is vibrant, high contrast, and smooth. and also make my circuit board repair look much better. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Visit us at www.bchtechnology.com or locally at Greensboro, North Carolina. Cheers!